Hello friends, welcome to LearnVern. Last time we discussed what is R, and today we will discuss how is R environment.
Now you have downloaded R and RStudio and they are ready to use. Now let us move to introducing of R programming. R is an integrated suite for data manipulation, calculations and graphical display. R has many features which are listed on your screen. Some of them are its variety of graphical display, its operators, data manipulation and data munging. Now this was about a small introduction of R programming. Let us move to what we call as R and statistics. Many classical and modern statistical functions have been implemented in R in the form of packages. When you install R, some of the packages are installed with it and to them we call as base packages. The packages which are not installed with R, you can download it from the CRAN networks. So let us know what are these packages. R functions and its calculations are stored in the form of packages. When you load the package, it is then only you are able to use the package. So there are certain commands to know about the packages. Library function with empty parentheses will let you know which are the packages installed in your R library. Library with the name of package inside the parentheses will load the library if it is present in the R system. If not, then you can download it by the command install.packages and the name of the package within the parentheses. So this is the way you can know the which packages are installed in your system. If not, how to install them and how to load them in your system. There is something called as dependent packages. For example, when I load a package, it is possible that it is also dependent on some another package. So it is essential for you to download those packages also. So when you allow R to download its dependencies also, it will also download its dependent packages.
So this was all about packages. Now let us see how do you run these three commands: library, if you want to install any package, and if you want to load a package in your system. I'd open RStudio and I'll minimize this to open my scripting language. Now the very first command was library with empty parentheses. The use for that library was to see which packages are installed in our R. So these packages will be called as base package. Now let me type the command library with empty parentheses. Press escape. I don't want to load any command, but I just want to see which packages are available in my system. I'll press Ctrl Enter and it will give me the list of packages available in my system. So these are all the packages which are already available. Now let's say if you want to load any package, for example, there is a package in R called as car, C-A-R car. So if I want to load that package, I'll write library car and press Enter. So it will be giving me an error in the bottom. It says error in library car, there is no package called car available. So this indicates me I had to install this package. I'll write install.packages and write car. Press Ctrl Enter. You can see the download has been started, but it is not downloading one package, but it is downloading multiple packages. Once the download will be completed, it will show which packages have been downloaded. You can see in the console window, there are multiple packages that have been downloaded apart from car. So these all the packages are called as dependent packages. So if you want to use a package car, you also need to have all the above packages also. Alternatively, if you want to download any package, you can go on the bottom right. You can press install and type car. So it will give you the list of all the packages which has spelling car and you can download appropriate package. So these are the two ways, one by writing a command and one by using the UI of RStudio.
Now we had seen R packages. Let us move with R commands. Basically R is a technical language and it is case sensitive. When I say case sensitive, then a variable with a small letter A is quite different than a variable with a capital letter A. All alphanumeric symbols are allowed in R. In the assignment operators, When I say assignment operators, that means when I assign a value to a variable, and then if I want to check that variable, it won't be printed automatically. There is a different command to print the value of a variable. Now let us discuss something about working directories and path. R has fundamentals of working directories and path. Whenever you load a session, then it will refer to a certain path. All read and write operations will refer to this path only. If the path is not set, and when you want to read a file from a specific folder stored in your system, then you need to specify that path. For example, let us say my file ABC, which is an Excel file, is stored on D drive. In that, I have a R programming named folder, in that I have chapter 1 named folder, and the file resides there. If I want to read this file, I need to give the entire path in my system. During my R session, if multiple times reading and writing of the file takes place, then there is a concept of setting the working directory permanently, so that every time you need not require to write the path. How to set that working directory? How to know what is a working directory? We will demonstrate you practically. So this is what about working directories and path in R.
So when you start your RStudio, you will have some default working directory. If you want to know that working directory, you have to write the command get working directory. It's get wd and empty parentheses. If you are writing in the scripting part of RStudio, then you need to press Ctrl Enter. In the console window, it will show you C users admin desktop as the current working directory. If you want to change this working directory, let's say I'm typing the same part. If you want to set this working directory permanently in an R session, so how do you do that? So you write set WD in the parentheses, you write the entire path. Let's say I want to write this path only, paste it here and press Ctrl Enter. So this is how my working directory can be set. You need to keep in mind the slash that is seen in the path has to be in the same way. If by default it is like this, you need to check about the backslash. By default, when you copy a path from the Windows, it will be forward slash. For example, if it is forward slash, it will give you an error. So there are two ways to do it. Either you keep two forward slash or one backward slash. If you write one more forward slash, then it will work. So you need to take care of the forward and the backward slash while writing the working directory path.
The last topic of the chapter is getting the R help. When you are stuck with any of your function, you can type help, and within parentheses, you can write the name of the function. You will be able to see the help, what are the operators, what are its parameters of the function, and you can move on. Alternatively, you can type a question mark before a function, and the same will be able to display it on your screen. So this was all about getting help in R. This was also the last topic of the chapter. So in this chapter, we saw history of R, installing R programming, and we also saw the R environment. In R environment, we saw R commands, packages, its working directories and path, and how to get R help.
So this was all about R environment, and in the next topic will be what are objects in R.